and that's when the Jewish people will be raised. They're going to share that glorious kingdom with us. What an hour it's going to be.
Jack, that is so interesting. Yeah. Really, Old Testament, New Testament, yeah. They blend together, yeah. Don't they?
Right.
That is tremendous. Friends, we have a brand new offer for you. I just know that you're going to be very enthused to order this Jerusalem Countdown to Armageddon. Take a look at the preview, please.
Medical scholars believe that the division of Jerusalem between the Palestinians and Jews will ignite the nuclear flames of Armageddon, World War III. Why? Jerusalem is the one and only sacred place globally for Jews to worship Yahweh, their eternal God. Muslims have Mecca, Medina, and demand Jerusalem to worship Allah. Do they need three global spots? Why, when they daily pray facing Mecca? The Holy Bible states 930 times that Jerusalem belongs exclusively to the Jews. The Quran never mentions Jerusalem once, zilch, zero. And yet President Obama has promised the holy city to the Palestinian Muslims. Who's responsible for this mess? For 1,700 years, Christian leaders have brainwashed millions of untaught and unconcerned Christians, corrupting them through a doctrine called replacement theology, which helped raise Hitler to power and the murder of 6 million Jews. But it's about to end. Why? For a startling documentation of scores of known and unknown facts, order Jerusalem Countdown to Armageddon.
That is so exciting. Please do not put off making that call, because I have a gift with your order. When you order Jerusalem, I'm going to be giving you one of Jack's books, Israel's Final Holocaust. And we talk not only about what happens leading to Armageddon, but how the peace comes. Woo! It's exciting, Jack.
Oh, there's so many of these Christian churches and denominations that are completely confused about Israel. Get this, and this 165-page book is a gift when you order the video, and you'll have the entire history, and you'll be able to answer any question concerning Jerusalem in the future.
Jerusalem Countdown to Armageddon. I don't like to talk about Armageddon, but it is coming. How's it going to stop? Well, with your order, this gift, make the call. There it is, right there, or right. Friends, I just wish that we could be with you a little bit longer, but we're so happy that we can come into your home every single week with an updated global headline for you. Now, our nation came together, as you well know, this moved my heart so much, to remember those who lost their lives in the 9/11 terrorist attack. And there we are, nation stops to remember. Unsettled nation marks 9/11 with rituals of sorrow. There you see it. Now, not time to build mosque near ground zero. They're all saying it. Islam and the West, suspicious in fear of Muslims, fanned by politicians in recent events, is once again spurring furious debate. Ground Zero Mosque. Obama inflames the debate. And there you see Ayman Roth. We are not at war against Islam. We are at war against terrorist organizations that have distorted Islam. That is our president speaking. And here you see Dr. Tim LaHaye, the author of the Left Behind series, Deceivers Are at the Door of New York City. Here's what he had to say. What a temple to the most cruel and murderous belief system in history. I do not know which is worse, the Islamists who have murdered millions in their false claim of peace, or the president of the American administration that welcomes their religious imams to the White House for dinner, yet will not attend our National Day of Prayer in the nation's capital. This is scandalous, by Dr. Tim
LaHaye. God forgive him.
LaHaye. And tensions still on boil in mosque fight. They can't come to an agreement. A failed bomb plot revives terrorism fears. Well, oh my. And take a look at this. Radical Islam is world's greatest threat. Who's saying that? The former UK Prime Minister Tony Blair, very concerned about radical Islam. Friends, two religious leaders took opposing views about building the mosque near 9/11. Of course, you saw the one. Ayman Roth is the one, and then the pastor of the Dove World Outreach Center in Florida, who wanted to burn the Quran. Very, very wrong. Now, are they both wrong? Jack, what is your opinion on this? Are they both wrong?
Roxella, it was a matter of pride in both of them. Jones had 31 people, and now he is known worldwide. And the other one, Ayman Roth, went to the Muslim lands right after that. And oh, they've boasted him and praised him. And it all has to do with being proud and getting known. And it's the wrong motive to do anything. Now, how can I say this about Ayman Roth? Have you ever heard of the Cordoba House? That's what he is going to call this structure. Now, that is an insult to Americans. Why? The Muslims went to war with the Spanish Christians and won, and so they made Cordoba their capital to ridicule the Christians who had been defeated. It was their way of boasting. We won. We're the victors. And I'm sure that Ayman Roth knew what he was doing when he said, we will call this structure at Ground Zero Cordoba House to mock the Christians. We wouldn't know it unless we were history buffs. Now you know it, and it's wrong. And both men wanted to exalt themselves. And my Bible says, pride goeth before destruction, and a haughty spirit before a fall. Proverbs 16:18. And here's the way all of us should be. 2 Chronicles 7:14. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land.
Whoa, Jake, that is such a good explanation about the war that they had there. Now, radical Islam is world's greatest threat. Tony Blair, remember I gave you that headline? Well, we know that there are so many peace-loving Muslims, but is it wrong, is it misleading to say that only Al-Qaeda is responsible for the hatred, for the great threat that Tony Blair is talking about there? How about it, Jack?
The only media is saying that our president made it worse by his comment. We are not fighting a war with Islam. We are fighting a war with Al-Qaeda. Come on, where do you get your information, Mr. President? You need some new writers who can put it up on the teleprompter so you can tell us what's really happening. You won't, I will. Just Al-Qaeda? What about the Taliban? What about Hamas, Hezbollah, and now the new one in Uganda, Al-Shabaab? Is going to be the most dangerous one in history. That's only a beginning. What about the 85,000 Sunnis and Shiites who killed one another in the war in Iraq right now because the Wahhabites, bin Laden, was behind them pushing it? They want to get rid of all Sunnis and Shiites because they are apostates according to bin Laden. But there's so many groups. Right now, Iran, Ahmadinejad, president of the land, said, we are going to send 40,000 suicide bombers who are Shiites to destroy many of the people of America as they release them and jump on them with their bodies and bombs. What about Shabazz, who says we're going to join and help the Palestinians and is a friend of Ahmadinejad of Iran? And right now, we have Hezbollah, who is moving into Shabazz and getting recruits be able to make a missile base to hit the United States of America. God forgive us. I'm telling you, we're in real trouble. And we need love in religion today. That's why Hamas, the son of Hamas, has just found Jesus and said, I found it through reading the Gospels and the New Testament. I was filled with hatred. But he said, I read what Jesus said in John 13:35. By this shall all men know you are my disciples, because you have loved one for another. 1 John 2:9, he that saith he is in the light and hates his brother is in darkness. 1 John 3:14, we know we've passed from death unto life because we love the brethren. And listen to this, whosoever hates his brother is a murderer. Again, whosoever hates his brother is a murderer, and no murderer has eternal life. You kill people and you'll end up in a devil's hell, Revelation 21:8 and Revelation 22:15, and you can forget about your 72 virgins for all eternity. And my Bible says this is one of the last signs. Jesus said in Matthew 24:37, as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. How was it in that day? The world was filled with terrorism, Genesis 6:11. And Jesus said in Luke 21:9, when you hear of wars and commotions, wars and terrorism, wars and revolutionaries, then what? You know something is about to happen. What? Then shall they see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory, verse 27. And he said in verse 31, when you see all these things happening, you know my kingdom, my coming to earth, the setup, that glorious thousand-year reign of mine is right at the door. And the generation that lives to see these things shall not pass. You and I are that generation.
Well, I'll tell you, Jack, I wish we had more time to get in to many more of the headlines that I gave to you right up front. Mideast Peace Talks begin. We'll talk about that next week. For sure, it's so important. But Jack just mentioned that we're living in the end times, the times just before the return of the Lord. And if the Lord came in the clouds today, would you say, welcome, Lord? Or would you say, I'm not ready. I'm not ready for you to come back yet. Friends, I guarantee that you can be ready and have peace in these troublesome, troublesome times. Jack, would you show us how we can all be ready?
This book says that Christ is the Prince of Peace, Isaiah 9:6, and he made peace through the blood of his cross. Look at me and pray this. If you mean it, you'll be saved today and ready for heaven. Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner. Thank you that you love sinners and that you died to take all my sin on you at Calvary. Lord Jesus, thank you. Thank you for what you did for me. I cast all my sin on you this day. Cleanse me. Save me. In your holy name, I pray this. Amen.
Amen. I love that. Cleanse me, save me. Isn't it wonderful to know that when Jesus comes in, he does cleanse us of anything in our lives we've done? Good to be clean, isn't it? Write me. There's my address. First Steps in a New Direction. I will send this to you absolutely free. So when you just say, Rexall, I made that decision, this will be in the mail. First Steps in a New Direction. I promised right away. Now, friends, oh, please make this call very, very soon. Jerusalem's countdown to Armageddon. Born in war and bound for peace. I like that saying, born in war and bound for peace. Here's our announcer to tell you how you can receive it. Chuck?
My friend, to order your copy of Jerusalem Countdown to Armageddon on DVD or VHS, have your credit card ready and call toll-free 24 hours a day, 1-800-JVI-7777. To order by mail in the U.S., send your donation of $24.95 to Jack Vanapee Ministries, Box 7004, Troy, Michigan, 48007. In Canada, send your donation of $24.95 to Jack Vanapee Ministries of Canada, Box 1717, Postal Station A, Windsor, Ontario, NINA6Y1. My friend, call today for this incredible video by the prophecy experts. Rexella?
Oh, my. Thank you so much, Chuck. I'm very excited. Make the call right now. I just want to say that I have a very good saying for you as we close today. God says, be you fishers of men, and we should fulfill that. So, be fishers of men. You catch them, and God will clean them.
Amen.
How true. How wonderful to trust in the Lord today. I trust that you will obey him in everything in your life. I look forward to being your home again next week. And until then, remember, God cares for you, and so do we so very much. Bye-bye. God bless you. Until next week.